Hello students, welcome to the English video class. Today we are going to deal with types of essays. Don't think that you are not having essays. It will help you to write your general paragraph. So listen carefully. What is an essay? An essay is a prose composition which presents a writer's perspective on a subject. An essay is a prose composition which presents a writer's perspective on a subject. It is usually written in prose and not in poetic form. Most essays attempt to discuss a topic or simply communicate a personal experience or belief. An essay can be fairly brief or quite long. It is a versatile and flexible literary form. What are the characteristics of essay? Unity and coherence are the characteristics of well-written essays. Any topic can be the subject of an essay. It is a very flexible literary form that enjoys the freedom which other forms of literature do not have. There are four types of essays. What are they? Do you know? Yes, first one is narrative, second one is descriptive, third one is argumentative, and fourth one is expository. Let's see one by one. First one is narrative essay. It deals with the telling of a personal experience, whether it can be single personal event, a series of related events, or a historical occurrence. Commonly, the events are presented in chronological order. What is chronological order? The incidents happened one by one. You have to tell the incidents one by one in order. Nevertheless, the writer is free to move around in time and organize the events from present to past using the technique called a flashback. What is flashback? A flashback provides a break in the straight chronological order of narrating events. What is flashback? A flashback provides a break in the straight chronological order of narrating events. Its purpose is to introduce material or information from the past. The writer must connect each event in the time span to other events that come before or after. Transition words of time serve as bridges to connect the various moments in the narrative pattern. In the narrative essay, there must always be some purpose for the telling of events, a purpose that goes beyond the story itself. The narration of events is just a means to an end, a way to support a central idea or thesis. Now, I hope you have understood what is a narrative essay. Shall we see an example for narrative essay? Yes. Listen to the story carefully. The Rescue. Rescue is the title of this essay. Everything had been totally different that Sunday morning. The two boys had set out on their walk up the cool, pine-scented mountainside near the village where they lived. Near the top, Peter and Michael had climbed onto a rock to admire the view of the valley far below them. That was when disaster had struck. On clambering down, Peter had tumbled awkwardly to the ground, his leg bent at a painful angle beneath him. Unable to move, he was forced to wait where he was, wrapped in Michael's jacket, while Michael had begun the long trek down the mountainside to fetch help. Michael looked down on the mountainside from the window of the helicopter. He felt increasingly helpless as it looked totally different from the air, and the network of tiny paths was mostly obscured from view by the thick covering of pine trees. To make matters worse, the light was fading fast and a thick blanket of mist was starting to form. Eventually, the pilot and the three mountain rescue workers in the helicopter agreed that they would have to go back and continue the search for Michael's friend Peter on foot. By 7 o'clock that evening, they had left the helicopter in the village and gathered a mountain rescue team of 15 men. Michael felt disheartened and scared for his friend's safety. Slowly, they ascended the mountain, scouring the numerous paths for Peter. The only sounds were crunching footsteps and the crackle of static on the walkie-talkies that the rescue workers carried to talk to each other. The mountainside was an eerie place after nightfall, and gradually Michael started to wonder whether they would ever find Peter at all. Suddenly, Michael heard a voice come over one of the walkie-talkies. "We have got him. We were taking him down." "I'm sorry," said Michael to his friend later in the warm safety of the hospital room. "I didn't realize it would take so long." The doctors decided to keep Peter at the hospital for the night in case of complications with his leg. Before leaving, Michael looked down at his friend and patted his shoulder as, silently, they both vowed never to go walking in the mountains again. Have you understood the story? Yes, likewise, you have to arrange the events in order. This is a beautiful example for narrative essay. Then, shall we go to the next one? That is descriptive essay. Descriptive essay uses sensory images to present a vivid picture of someone or something. Descriptive essay uses sensory images to present a vivid picture of someone or something. Descriptive writing relies on sensory images that appeal to the sense of sight, sound, smell, touch, and taste. Often, these images are made more effective by the use of figurative language. The author's feelings about the subject are clearly expressed in the controlling idea. All details are carefully selected to convey the author's feeling through the creation of a dominant impression of its subject. To create that impression, the author may use descriptive language, that is, objective, straightforward, precise, and factual. This kind of language is called denotative, and it makes use of neutral dictionary meanings. What is denotative? To create impression, the author may use descriptive language, that is, objective, straightforward, precise, and factual. This kind of language is called denotative. Then what is connotative? If the description is subjective, the writer may use connotative language, that is, language which suggests or implies something beyond the dictionary meaning. What is connotative? That is, language which suggests or implies something beyond the dictionary meaning. In brief, a word's denotation is the specific dictionary meaning of a word. Connotation, however, refers to the suggestive quality of words, the feelings or impressions that a word may awaken in the reader. Can you notice the difference between the two? Yes. Descriptive writing must have an organizational pattern that supports the dominant impression of the subject. Details in descriptive essays are usually arranged spatially, that is, from top to bottom, left to right, near to far, interior to exterior. But they can also be arranged emphatically. What is emphatically? More important to less important, less striking to most striking. Details could also be organized according to the sensory images they evoke. Have you all understood about descriptive essay? Shall we go to the next one? Next one is argumentative essay. The title itself gives the meaning. This essay tries to convince the reader of some opinion or persuade the reader to take action on an issue. What is argumentative essay? This essay tries to convince the reader of some opinion or persuade the reader to take action on an issue. Argumentation makes an appeal to the reader's intellect. When a writer is trying to persuade, the writer will also make a strong appeal to the reader's emotions. In this type of essay, the author takes a stand by offering a judgment of value, an interpretation of events, or a proposed course of action, and then providing reasons for readers to agree with it. The position of the writer is clearly stated in argumentative essay. A good statement is crucial to the essay. The last point about argumentative essay is this one. This stated position is an idea that can be debated or disputed and towards which the writer must take a definite side. Have you understood about argumentative essay? We are going to see the last type of essay, that is expository essay. You need not have examples for descriptive essay and argumentative essay. If you want, you can find out and you can write it on your own. Practice yourself to write on your own. It will be helpful for your exam purpose also. What is expository essay? It informs, explains, or analyzes a topic. What is expository essay? It informs, explains, or analyzes a topic. In this kind of essay, the thesis or controlling idea is frequently referred to as a generalization. What is generalization? A statement that mostly applies to a group of things, ideas, or people. This generalization can be a value judgment, an opinion, or a factual statement. Specific details help to prove or support the generalization. Factual details, examples, and illustrations are often used as support. The ideas in an expository essay are organized in a logical manner. Order of importance and order of familiarity are the two most frequently used forms of logical arrangement for expository essays. Shall we see an example for expository essays? This may be a new word for you. That's why I am going to give an example for you. The title is Exam Preparation. You have to write an expository essay about this topic. There are 8 strategies for reducing exam anxiety. Have you ever frozen on an exam? Found yourself unable to recall material during the exam and then recalled everything afterwards? Had trouble focusing on exam questions because of interfering thoughts? Yes, we all may have this. Here are 8 strategies to prevent this from happening again. Select which ones you think are most relevant for you. First one is maintain a healthy lifestyle. Get aerobic exercise on a regular basis. Sleep well and eat healthily. The second strategy is get accurate information. Check out the time and location of the exam well in advance. Know what to expect when you arrive at the exam, format of questions, what material the exam will cover, and how much it is worth, etc. The third point is study effectively. Study in 50-minute blocks with 10-minute activity or nutrition breaks. Learn memory enhancement techniques. Fourth point is prepare to write the exam. How will you prepare to write the exam? Eliminate extraneous sources of anxiety, such as how to get to the exam room, by figuring out that out in advance. Think about what commonly distracts you during exams. Example, frequent clock watching, noise from other students, etc. Develop strategies in advance for dealing with these distractions. Next point is adjust your attitude. Maintain an attitude of doing the best you can under the circumstances rather than requiring perfection from yourself. It is more important. Plan a reward for yourself after the exam. Praise yourself as you write the exam. Example, half done and so far so good. Next point is change unhelpful thoughts. Learn and practice over time how to challenge your negative thoughts. Example, I am going to fail, etc. Next point is use test taking strategies. Do a memory dump of information you are afraid you will forget on the back of the exam when you first receive it. Read through the exam at the beginning and figure out how much time to spend on each question according to what each question is worth. The last strategy is use anxiety reduction techniques. Learn and practice on a daily basis relaxation and visualization techniques, so they will come easily to you at exam time. Don't do any last minute preparation. It will make you tensed. While preparing for the exam, visualize a positive exam writing experience. So, don't think about any negative things. Write with confidence. That is the example for expository essay. Do you like that essay? It will be very, very useful and helpful for you always. Shall we recollect the points? Yes. I am going to recall you every type of essay. However, it is important to keep in mind that most essays are not pure specimens. For example, an expository essay may begin trying to convince the reader that a particular point of view or a particular brand of a technological device is the best. Or the essay may begin with a very brief narrative. Likewise, an argumentative essay may include some exposition. Till now, we have seen elaborately about essay writing. Now, I am going to give you the simple points to write essay. An essay is an attempt or a trial in writing a piece of composition. An essay should have a definite theme or purpose, a logical order and coherence, a good objective and style. Now, what about the structure of an essay? It should have a catchy introduction, main text that is divided into paragraphs, good conclusion. What is conclusion? Summing up the main idea. Before writing an essay, collect anecdotes, quotes, proverbs that would come in handy. While writing, what are the points you have to remember? First, jot down main points and sub points. Second one, sketch the first draft. Third one, read, revise, edit, correct, and proof and read it. Make a fair draft. We have read a nice cup of tea lesson in our second unit. It is itself a great example for essay writing. Who wrote the essay A Nice Cup of Tea? Yes, you are right. It is George Orwell. There are some famous essayists like Francis Bacon, Charles Lamb, J. Krishnamurti, whose essays will inspire you to write more. Will you try to write essays on your own? Yes. Now, I am going to give you assignment. You have to write the essays on your own words. Try and you can do. I am going to give you three topics. First one is the profession you would like to choose. The profession you would like to choose. Second one, the importance of a balanced diet. Second one, the importance of a balanced diet. And the last one, a memorable journey. The third topic is a memorable journey. Have you all taken down? Shall we see the next topic called article writing? Article writing is more similar to essay writing. These two topics will help you in your exam to write the general paragraph on your own. You need not write a big essay in your exam. You have to write a paragraph alone. Article writing. What is an article? An article is a written work published in a print or electronic medium for propagating news, research, analysis, etc. What is an article? An article is a written work published in a print or electronic medium for propagating news, research, analysis, etc. Example: scientific papers, blogs, Usenets, e-papers, and news articles. An article is a piece of writing penned for a large group of readers, usually intended for publication in newspapers or magazines. Therefore, the objective of writing an article should be to attract the attention of the readers and to retain their interest as well. The author of an article should be well informed about the subject and should have a wide knowledge of the same. He or she should be creative and should possess good vocabulary. He or she should develop the skill to organize and present ideas in coherent and logical manner. There are some salient points to remember while writing an article. First one is, provide a catchy or captivating title or heading. The first letter of every content word in the caption should begin with the capital letter. Second point, the title should give an idea of the subject to being dealt with. The title should be followed by the name of the author. Third point, try to conform to the prescribed word limit. Like in essay, we should not write article in an elaborate manner. Fourth point is, the language should be simple and formal. Fifth point, grammatical accuracy should be ensured. Sixth one, relevant value points should be gathered, not the unnecessary points. And the last point is, expand the ideas into 3 or 4 paragraphs. Then we are going to deal with the structure of the article. How should be the article? The first paragraph. How should we write the first paragraph? Define and introduce the topic. Begin the article with an interesting adage, a slogan, an amazing fact, or with some statistics, facts, and figures. How should be the second paragraph? Give a detailed explanation of the topic. Include the causes and effects. Refer to examples, anecdotes, experiences, and present state of affairs. Talk about merits and demerits, advantages and disadvantages. The third and the last paragraph, how can we write? The third paragraph should suggest suitable solutions for the problems discussed. And then it should give a proper conclusion. Now, have you all understood about article writing? Again, I am going to give you the assignment, not on my own. It is given in your textbook, page number 49. You take page number 49 in your books. There are two tasks given. The first one is, the government of Tamil Nadu has imposed a ban on the use of plastic. Effective implementation of this ban depends on public awareness and individual responsibility. The second task is, urban living brings with it a possibility of various communicable diseases. Now, write article for about 150 words for a leading newspaper. Now, write article for these two questions. This is for today's assignment. Thank you for listening. Have a nice day.
நிகழ்ச்சியை பற்றிய தங்களின் மேலான கருத்துக்களை கீழ்கண்ட முகவரிக்கு கடிதம் மூலமாகவோ மின்னஞ்சல் மூலமாகவோ குறுஞ்செய்தி மூலமாகவோ தெரியப்படுத்தலாம். அனுப்ப வேண்டிய முகவரி: சிறப்பு அலுவலர், கல்வி தொலைக்காட்சி, 8ஆம் தளம், அண்ணா நூற்றாண்டு நூலகம், காந்தி மண்டப சாலை, கோட்டூர்புரம், சென்னை 685. தொலைபேசி எண் 7824001500.